pass me by? Will you criticize me as I sit and cry? I had fought so hard and thought that all my battles had been won, only to find the war's just begun. Is he not strong enough? Is he not pure enough to break me, pour me out, and start again? Is he not brave enough to take one chance on me? But he's gonna have one chance to start again. My weakness for an hour make me suffer for a lifetime. Is there any way to be made whole again? If I'm healed, renewed, and find forgiveness, find a strength I've never had, will my scars forever ruin all God's plan? He took my life into his hands and turned it all around. In my most desperate circumstance, it's there I finally found that you were.
Angela. We've known each other for a really long time, since we were kids. And ever since that first moment, I knew I wanted you in my life forever. We've been through a lot, good, bad, ugly. But even the bad times that we had together were better than the good times that we had apart.
Go ahead.
You've always been my best friend. And even through all my faults and shortcomings, you still saw the man of God in me. And you allowed me to lead you. Wow.
You got it. Break it down.
You help edify me and encourage spiritual growth in my life. God has me on a journey. And up until this point, I've been walking it alone. But now, I want you to come with me. Will you marry me?
Incredible. Anthony came here when he was about, I guess, eight, something along that line. Angela was five when she got here. I watched them grow as individuals. They both have suffered trials and human failures. And through it all, they've learned to heal and to be healed. They learned to grow as people, as Christians, to the degree to where now they're at that stage in their life where they no longer want to go with this thing alone. Isn't it good to be in a place where people can grow together and love through failure, through struggle, through success? Hallelujah. Now, listen, there are no shortage of people who would love to see any ministry fall and make their effort to seek to destroy and divide by pointing out all the inconsistencies and et cetera. And there are inconsistencies. Will you say amen to that? If I swore to you that you were walking into a perfect church, my nose would grow an inch per letter. Praise the Lord. But this is a perfect place for imperfect people. And Anthony has rewarded this church with his gift, his talent, his time, his energy. He's one of the many people who God has blossomed here. Amen. Thank him and Angela for their involvement and investment in this ministry. Now it's time for this church to give back to them. Let's pour into their new family what God has blessed with so many other families before them. Can we all do that? Let's stand and celebrate Anthony and Angela on this wonderful day of celebration. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.